As soon as we get back to England, we're going to start prepping for the aeroplane or the airport sequence, along with the actual house, sinking house sequence, which is at the end, and also the car turnover, the Aston Martin car turnover.
Once again, Bond's car of choice is the Aston Martin. And as usual, the stunt boys are determined to give it a thorough road test, this time by rolling it as many times as they can.
We started working on the Aston roll, that must have been about 2 months ago now. We started off in BMWs and using a 6-inch ramp, just turning into the ramp at about 65, 70 miles an hour and rolling the car like that. So we did two rehearsals at that, did one rehearsal run in an Aston Martin, and then realised after doing the test with that that the car was slightly more stable and grippy on the road, that the ramp wasn't going to be, or the ramp at that 6 inches of height wouldn't quite be the right height for the Aston. So then on the day that we shot it, we raised the ramp up to about 18 inches, just under 2 foot, to try and get that extra bit of lift. Then went again at similar sort of speed, 70, 75 miles an hour, hit it. We were hitting it with just one side of the car, obviously to try and get it to pitch over onto to get into a roll. As we hit it, it just completely leveled off and landed back on all four wheels and slid down the road completely unscathed, pretty much.
To the Astons, obviously they're built completely different. The centre of gravity is lower. They're basically a race car that's allowed on the road. And when we did the first one on the ramp, it basically went up in the air, corrected itself and come back down again. So we had a backup plan, which was the cannon inside the Aston, and that's what we used.
Special effects guys had put in a cannon which sits just behind the driver's seat, which has a cylinder that then, as you press a button, releases a load of air, which punches the cylinder into the road, which then in turn turns the car over. My main concern was literally just get one roll out of it and I'll be happy, sort of thing.
So let's do any final checks, guys, and get ready to shoot. And action.
It's a fairly violent sort of ride. You do get thrown around a fair bit inside, and it's just a case of really holding on, and as the car's going over, you're anticipating the impacts.
The car rolled a staggering 7 times. The stunt team think they may have a world record.
The car program on TV went for the world record and they got 5. Now we beat that by 2, so we're sort of checking to see if that's the official world record now, which would be nice if it is.
I went to go and do as many as I possibly could. Well, I think I was doing just over 70 miles an hour, about 75, when I hit the button. Just took off really. Once it started to go and it bit into the grass, there was no stopping it really.
Over and over and over again. Great as well because they did the close-up on Eva. And he did the car swinging around and it rolled again. So they have it from every angle. It's fantastic.